Good afternoon, guys. Today we are going to look at error recovery in predictive parsing or LL1 parsing, the theory portion. In addition to that, let us see one example. Although it occurs error, how the parser is parsing, how it is recovering from that error. Look at this example. I am committing one error. Look at, without anything open bracket and close bracket, there is no such construct available. Anything, we can assume whichever the wrong way of representing input, any combination you can assume. I am assuming this combination, open bracket close bracket combination, for the above grammar which we have discussed in the previous session. With that, we are going to complete this understanding. Now let us start with how the syntactic error occurs. Whenever syntactic error occurs, if the given input is not obeying the CFG rules or syntactic rule, or goes against any word, whichever you want, you can use. When the stream of tokens coming from the lexical analyzer, subsequently it should obey the rules of CFG, or going against of the CFG rules, context-free grammar rules or syntactic rule. If it violates, or it disobeys, or it goes against whatever the word you say, that all termed as syntactic error. How we can handle the syntactic error? One method is report error. Just announce to the user, this is the mistake you have done, so and so mistake, you need to correct. Just giving the report, that is one method. Especially Turbo C, whenever you are working, it does this job only, giving the error notification. But error recovery mechanism is much more advanced compiler. Now let us see what is other duty of error handler. Recover from discovered errors. Our topic of discussion is recover from discovered errors. That's it. Now we are looking at the compiler, not the C compiler, general compiler design. Any compiler, when it detects syntactic error, either it can report or it can recover. These are all the two primary jobs. What else? Third one. It should aim at not slowing down the processing of the remaining program. Whenever any compiler designer, compiler constructor, construction time, whomever designs a compiler, they should look into this aspect as well. Not only recovering from the error occurrence, or not only reporting, it should not slow down the remaining process of the compiler. Always it should keep up the fast processing. It should do the job quickly. So this is what we are, the thumb rules we are considering for the error recovery routine. This is what last class we have discussed. When the terminal on the top of the stack does not match with the input symbol, then it is said to be error situation. When it will happen? The stack content and the input buffer mismatch is happening. Top of the stack symbol is not matched with leftmost symbol of the input, that is called error situation. This is one type of error, one scenario of error. What else would be the other scenario of error? When non-terminal A on the top of the stack, A is the next input symbol, but the parse table is empty. Last class only we filled all the empty table, what to be done for each and every combination. Till the last class, the table was empty. So if it is empty, what it's supposed to do, how it's supposed to do. Then table of row and column, in order to understand by you, by a common layman, if you are not clear about this sentence technicality, if the row and the column of the table is not matched or not, it is empty, that is also error situation. These are all the two situations error will occur. One is input symbol and the input buffer symbol, stack symbol should not match. Terminal and the terminal mismatch. Always we used to see, no, terminal will be on the top of the stack, terminal will be under scanning of the input buffer, both will become same. ID, ID, star, star, plus, plus, always both became same in the previous discussion which we have seen. Long back, types of parser time. That mismatch happens, that is also one type of error. The combination, top of the stack is non-terminal, the symbol which is under consideration is a terminal, non-terminal, terminal, always we look into the table, lookup table. While looking into the table, if that entry becomes empty, that is also error situation. These are all the two circumstances we will have error. How we are going to recover, that is what the discussion. There are two methods. One is panic mode error recovery. Another one is phrase level recovery. The table which we have constructed in the previous class is related to panic mode recovery. Now, how the panic mode recovery does? This is what we were doing in the last class. The complete table construction is meant for error recovery for predictive parsing. Look at, if parser looks up entry capital A, comma A, finds it blank, then the input symbol is terminal A, then we need to do skip. I was filling skip. So that is what I was filling skip. The better word is scan, not a skip, but we have filled with the skip. That is also fine. No worries. We need to skip. If the entry is sync, what is the meaning of sync is we always look into follow. That follow symbols upon that column, we have written pop. That is called syncing element, syncing terminals. Then the non-terminal or terminal, you can write either non-terminal on top of the stack is popped in an attempt to resuming the parse. Whenever we have written on the table pop word, that all said to be synchronization. Look at the table. We have written pop. When we have written pop, if the follow symbol has that close bracket. So this is called synchronizing tokens. Whenever this is technical aspect, the terminology. But those days we have written pop. Instead, we can write synchronizing token, sync. We can write just sync. Synchronizing token are used with pop action. So this is called sync. Next, if the token on the top of the stack does not match the input symbol, then we pop the token from the stack. Another scenario, terminal and terminal is not matched, then simple pop of the stack. These are all the three actions we are going to do. If you have got doubt, you can question me. One is, if the blank entry comes for this, then A is skipped. That is why we have written skip. Next is we have written pop. To whom we have written pop is all the synchronizing tokens based on the follow computation, we have filled the pop. Third is top of the stack does not match the input symbol. Terminal and terminal doesn't match us. Simply we are popping from the stack. Two things we need to do. If terminal and terminal is not matched, we need to pop the content of the stack as well as we need to skip the input term. Symbol. We will be looking into one example through that you can understand much better the theory portion. Now let us come to panic mode recovery. What are all the concepts we are doing, or what is the meaning of panic mode recovery? The parser discards the input symbol one at a time until one of the designated set of synchronizing tokens are found. Synchronizing token is what? That pop, whenever we are writing pop, until input symbol is skipped, it will kept on skipping. So whenever the synchronization token is found, until then skip process is happening. That is the one strategy we are adapting within panic mode recovery. Simple, and it goes, and it does not go to infinite loop. Because of this table entries, never it will go to infinite loop. Adequate when the presence of multiple errors in a statement occurs also. This panic mode recovery is better if multiple error occurred in a single statement also. Never it will go to infinite loop. That is the advantage of panic mode recovery. The entire table construction which we have done in the previous class is example for panic mode recovery, this entire table. Now, coming to phrase level recovery. The parser performs local correction on remaining input when the error is discovered. This is what phrase level recovery. Local correction is called phrase level recovery. How it does the local correction? Let us see. The parser replaces the prefix of the remaining input by some string. It will start substituting, and when it will start finding where the error is not available, until that point it will scan, it will keep on scanning. Then the prefix portion will have the error. That entire errored prefix portion, it will attempt to replace by the appropriate combinations of that prefix. This is how phrase level error recovery is happening. This is called local correction. But it is very tough to implement. Very tough to implement. But there is a theoretical framework proposed for another type of recovery mechanism. See, which allows the parser to carry on its execution, replaces the prefix of the remaining input by some string. This method difficult to find the occurred error. So it is very difficult to find the error. Until that error combination, it needs to form. How it can form the error combination is, the moment it finds the non-error or appropriate context or perfect token, till then everything else is grouped as error combination. For that entire error combination, substituting suitable combination of tokens is what called phrase level error recovery. What are all the challenges in it? Forming that errored portion is the number one challenge. Number two, replacing it by appropriate combination of tokens is number two challenge. Normally, theoretically, this proposal will come whenever it is possible. They will be adapting not to the perfect level. There is no common algorithm for this. That is why it is called local correction. Whereas panic mode error recovery is a common algorithmic method. That is called global correction. Anyone across the globe can able to do across the entire programming construct. So this is the introduction of two types of error recovery. Let us go back to revisiting of the problem which we discussed in the previous class. This is a given CFG. We started constructing first and follow. Subsequent to the first and follow, we started constructing the table. POP or synchronizing token, both are same. This is called POP. Action is POP. Where we are doing this POP is synchronizing token. This is called synchronizing token. Whereas this is called synchronizing token only for the row number one, not for other rows. That's why I can't write here synchronizing token. Rather, I'm writing here POP or sync. In the earlier class, I have written skip. Instead, the appropriate technological word is scan. You need to scan the next symbol. That is skip only. You will be skipping the present symbol and you will be scanning further. So skip means there is no other way to write the routine. Rather, if I write scan, move forward, if I write move forward, go to the next symbol, then we have the routine to write. That is why we are replacing gently the skip by scan, nothing else. Now let us consider this input. See, no one will write input like this. Open bracket, close bracket, ID plus ID star, ID dollar. This is what input buffer or input string which I am considering. Now stack initially need to be loaded with the dollar and the starting symbol. Now we need to look at what pair. Again, question answer session. What pair of combination, capital A, small a, one non-terminal, one terminal. We need to look into the table now. What is a pair I need to look at? Excellent. E and open bracket. E and open bracket, I'm going to look at. It says T produces T E dash. I need to copy this. I need to come back. I need to replace that E by this symbol. Then the input symbol going to become the same. Now to whom I need to look at? Now what is a pair? I looked at the combination capital E and open bracket. That entry was T. T and excellent. T and open bracket. Now I need to look at the first symbol is T. Top of the stack is T. Input symbol under consideration is open bracket, T open bracket. Let us look into T open bracket. It says FT dash. T and open bracket says FT dash. Then the remaining is E dash and dollar I need to copy. Let me copy and delete T. Don't worry. I have copied. Still the input string remains the same. Now what combination I need to look at the table? Excellent. F open bracket. This is the top of the stack. This is a symbol under consideration. F open bracket. Look at F and open bracket says GG dash. I need to replace F open bracket by GG dash. I need to retain the remaining combination. Now the input buffer is same. What is the pair I need to look at now? G open bracket. Very good. Advance. G open bracket. See, now the combination is, this is the top of the stack. G open bracket is a symbol under consideration. G open bracket. Look at what it says. Open bracket. E. Then the remaining I need to retain except G. Now the combination of the stack is same. Now what and what I need to look at? Open and open bracket matches. When it is matches, I need to pop this topmost content, delete, open bracket matches. When it matches, I need to scan the next content. There is no error. I assumed that error, it works well. There is no error. I need to change the input in different way with absolute mismatch, like I need to do it. Right now it matches. Although the syntactic way of writing is wrong, it works perfect. Till now there is no problem. Open bracket and open bracket matches. So I need to scan or I need to skip. Here I need to pop. Pop operation we did. See, this is what the combination we have seen. Open bracket, open bracket. This symbol I need to skip or scan. Scan to the next. This symbol I need to pop. Now, which combination again? Open, capital E, open bracket. Capital E, open bracket, if I look at the same combination. Sorry, capital E, open bracket, look at. Now we got, excellent. This is the right example only. E and open bracket, pop it is telling. Could you able to understand how the error recovery is happening? In between, nothing I have given. So it is error. The given input is absolutely error. Auto recovery is happening. Excellent example only I have brought. I myself have written this, so it suits well. Could you able to understand now? See, E and open bracket, earlier it was empty. That is called error situation. How we are trying to recover? Through synchronization of the token, synchronizing token, or else pop. Simply you write pop. Technically, that terminology is called synchronizing token. Whenever we found the synchronizing token, what we supposed to do is, whatever is dictated here, it is dictated here is what? Pop. It says pop. I need to pop the topmost of the symbol. Could you get my point? What I'm doing now? Now simply I need to eliminate. Popped out. Excellent example it has come. Popped. Earlier it was no miss, no match. Let us see. Yeah, match is happening. Yes, excellent. Open, close bracket, match is happening. Now only one error we have seen. That one error, it was empty. Then we have recovered by dictating that action by pop. Now just because of pop, we are not facing error anymore. Immediately matching is happening. Whenever match happens, we need to pop the topmost content of the stack. We need to scan the next symbol. Now we have come to appropriate token. So far now we were having problem with the token. Now we are with the absolutely right token combination. Now this moment onwards, we are absolutely right. No more error. From this, what we have done, the earlier grammar we have seen, but now the grammar is different. So we need to work on, we need to fill the remaining also. Now let us proceed further. Now what is the combination I need to look at? Top of the stack is G dash and input symbol under consideration is ID. For the pair G dash and ID, yes, absolute. G dash and ID I need to look at. G dash is the row pair, ID is the column. It says me scan. G dash and ID combination says me scan. So what I am doing, I move to the next symbol. G dash and plus ID scan. Now G dash and plus, look at G dash and plus epsilon. Now we need to replace by, could you able to get my point, ma'am? G dash and ID, for that combination it says me just go and scan. So that we are moving here. Next we are looking at G dash and plus. G dash and plus, what is available here? Epsilon. Then G dash become empty. The remaining combination I need to write down. Now again I need to write down the remaining combination. T dash, 1 minute. T dash and ID. Scan, T dash and ID. Now after this 1 minute, we started and this ID. Already we scanned these two. Under plus only, we did the combination G dash and plus. G dash and plus substituted, G dash become empty. Now we need to look at T dash and plus. T dash and plus. It says to replace T dash by empty. The remaining would become E dash and dollar. The input we started scanning, we are under this symbol consideration. No match happened, so that it is scanning. Just scanning is happening. Now E dash and plus. Look at E dash and plus. It dictates plus T E dash. Now we need to replace by plus T E dash dollar. Now the symbol input buffer, symbol under consideration plus. We reached this plus, plus and plus matches. So we need to pop and scan. So the remaining input would become this. Then here ID, this onwards ID only will come for the scanning. Now T and ID, we need to compare T and ID. If we look at, T and ID, it says FT dash. I need to copy FT dash. Then E dash dollar. FT dash, E dash dollar. The remaining inputs are this. Now I need to look at the pair FID. If I look at the pair FID, F and ID, GG dash. Need to replace by GG dash. F need to be erased. The remaining input will become the same. GID. G and ID, ID replaced by ID. The remaining inputs are G dash and ID. There is a match. When there is a match, I need to just pop and scan. The remaining inputs are this. Now I need to scan G dash star. G dash star. It says substitution of epsilon. Then remaining would become T dash E dash. T dash star. I need to scan now. T dash star. T dash star says star FT dash. I need to replace star FT dash E dash dollar. Now the same continues, star and star matches, so that remaining would become this token and ID dollar. Now FID combination, F and ID, again GG dash, GG dash, T dash, E dash dollar. Still going to become the same. GID, G and ID, ID, ID here as well. ID matches, remove. The remaining combination need to be retained. G dash. After this cancellation, the remaining would become this. Here it would become dollar, G dollar, sorry, G dash dollar. G dash and dollar says epsilon, so that it will be removed. Remaining is this, still becomes dollar, T dash dollar. I need to look at T dash dollar, epsilon. So I'm substituting T dash by dollar. The remaining would become E dash dollar because it becomes epsilon. Here, just a dollar. Next, E dash and dollar. If I look at E dash and dollar, epsilon substitutes. Remains dollar, here as well dollar. Dollar, dollar matches ends. Although we started with this wrong combination, only one time only we were doing that pop operation. Only one time only we did pop operation. Remaining every other symbol scanned appropriately. Because of that table only we are saved. Otherwise we would have get caught with that error. One time we have done, we have carried out that pop operation. Just because of that single pop operation, we started moving forward. We didn't get stuck up. That is the beauty of this panic mode error recovery. The table entry says scan and pop. Those two will save most of the error. So that combination is called panic mode error recovery. Do you have any doubt? With that, I'll just stop recording. Then you can discuss.